Hey everyone, Renee here again, and welcome back to my channel, Thai Caliente. If you haven't subscribed yet, please be sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. On today's show, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a very easy and flavorful salsa verde. So salsa verde is made with green tomatillos. I know you can find them in the can, but I can't vouch for the recipe. I've never made them with canned tomatillos. I've always been able to find fresh tomatillos at my grocery store, at my local grocery store for that matter. So you don't even need to go to a Hispanic grocery store to find the tomatillos. So I'm also guilty of buying jarred salsa when I'm in a hurry, but once I make my own salsa, it's just so much better. This is a pretty quick recipe. We're not doing any roasting. Everything is just gonna get boiled together and then blended in the blender. The salsa will develop more flavor once it sits in the fridge and cools down. And if you make a big batch and you wanna save some for later, I've even frozen the salsa in like a zip top freezer bag and just thawed it in the fridge overnight, and it still tastes really good. So it's a great time to make a big batch and have some salsa in your freezer for whenever you need it. So let's go ahead and get started on the salsa verde recipe. Like I mentioned, we're gonna be using fresh tomatillos. So fresh tomatillos have a waxy residue. So you wanna make sure you peel off that skin on them, that crumbly, crinkled skin that's on the tomatillo. And you wanna make sure you rinse them really good and just kind of wipe them off with a rag to get all of that waxy residue off. Let's go ahead and get started on this recipe. So as I mentioned, we need to start by peeling the tomatillos. So go ahead and peel them, and then I just have a strainer set aside to place them in, and I'm gonna let them soak in some water so that way it'll be easier to remove the waxy residue. The tomatillos have been soaking in a little bit of water, so now I'm just gonna get a kitchen rag and gently rub off any remaining waxy residue and then place them into a saucepan for boiling. To our saucepan, we're going to go ahead and add a jalapeno for spice. If you want it spicier, you can go ahead and add more. And then we're gonna do half of a white onion that I've just quartered, and go ahead and fill the pot up with water. Place a lid and bring it up to a gentle boil. The mixture will need to simmer for about 10 minutes till everything gets soft. Now we're ready to make our salsa in the blender. So add a big handful of cilantro and garlic cloves, and then the softened tomatillos, onions, and jalapeno. We're also going to add a little bit of the cooking liquid just so we can go ahead and get the salsa loosened up and blended well. So we're also going to add a little bit of salt to taste, and go ahead and place the lid on the blender and blend it to your desired consistency. I like my salsa pretty blended. Once the salsa verde is done blending, go ahead and pour it into a glass jar to cool in the fridge. It usually takes about an hour to cool down, and then serve it with your favorite chips, tacos, burritos, or pretty much anything else that you want to eat salsa verde with. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye!